Hi, in this video we are going to discuss about principal component analysis. It is an unsupervised learning algorithm and it is also used in dimensionality reduction. It is a simple non-parametric method of extracting relevant information from confusing data set. Say for instance we have 50 features in the data set x1, x2, x3, x50. There are 50 features in the data set. So which may lead to confusion by having all the attributes or having all whether or relevant or irrelevant attributes. To overcome this, PCA project all 50 into 20 features by taking only the relevant attributes. It doesn't mean that it skip all remaining 30. It doesn't mean that it project all features into 20, which brings into 20 features and project in such a way it reduces the dimensionality from 3D to 2D or 2D to 1D space. That is higher dimension space into lower dimension space. So statistical procedure that uses an orthogonal transformation to convert a set of observations of possibly correlated variables into a set of variable of linearly uncorrelated variable called principal components. So finally it gets relevant principal components, and it was invented in 1901 by Carl Pearson, independently developed and by Harold Hotling in 1930s. First applied in ecology by Goodall in 1954 under the name of factor analysis, also known as PFA, that is principal factor analysis. It is a way of identifying patterns in data and expressing the data in such a way as to highlight their similarities and differences. Since patterns in data can be hard to find in data of high dimension, so it is a powerful tool for analyzing the data, right, where the luxury of graphical representation is not available. The other main advantage of PCA is that once you have found these patterns in the data and you compress the data by reducing number of dimensions. If we have 100 dimensions, we reduce it with the 50 dimensions. If we have 2 dimensions, we may reduce into 1 dimension. Or we have 3 dimensions, we may reduce into 1 or 2 dimensions. So PCA is considered an exploratory technique that can be used to gain a better understanding of the interrelationship between variables. It is to perform on the set of data with the hope of simplifying the description of a set of interrelated variables. Variables are treated equally and they are not separated into dependent and independent variables. In simple terms, PCA transforms the original interrelated variables into new set of uncorrelated variables called principal components. An advantage of principal components to researchers is that the complexity in interpretation that can be caused by having a large number of interrelated variables by reducing by utilizing only the first few principal components that explains the large proportion of the total variation. So we'll be bringing down into principal components, out of which we select the principal components, not all having the highest value of the principal components. So thereby we'll be reducing the many principal components into very few. An important concept of PCA is that where it reduces number of variables or reduce dimensionality itself. So this decision has no hard set rules and that decision may seem subjective at times. So this is the role of PCA. So it captures major principal variability present in the data set and ignores smaller variability. So it captures all the principal components and ignore the lower values of principal components, and it helps in finding eigenvalues and eigenvectors. significant eigenvalues and eigenvectors are taken for decision pieces. So we use those values for deciding which principal components we are going to ignore and which one we are going to take. And PCA forms new coordinate system defined by the significant eigenvectors. That is, new coordinates will have lower dimensions. So we map data into that new space. That is, from higher dimension to lower dimension. This is principles of PCA. It works on linear projection method to reduce number of variables. Transfer a set of correlated variables into new set of uncorrelated variables. Map from low, that is high space to low dimension space. And PCA rotate existing axis to new positions in the space defined by original variable. So few things that you must understand clearly before we move on to the algorithm of PCA and its example. What is dimensionality? Dimensionality is, say we have the random variables, number of random variables in the data set, or simply we say it is a number of features. As I was saying, if there are 50 features, then 50 dimensionality. If there are 2 features, then 2 dimensionality. Correlation is how 2 variables are related to each other, strongly related to each other. The values of same ranges for minus 1 to plus 1. The positive indicates when one variable increases, other also increases. While negative indicates one decreases on increasing the former. Right? So correlation says the strong connection between 2 variables, like how x1, x2 both are related to each other. Orthogonal is how it is independent. There is no relation between 2 variables. How it is independent, correlated to each other. Eigenvector, so we consider a non-zero vector V. It is an eigenvector of a square matrix A. If AV is a scalar multiple of V, or simply AV is equal to lambda V. So a V is a eigenvector, lambda is a eigenvalue associated with it. And one more is covariance matrix. So this matrix consisting of covariance between pair of variables. So we have the, say, x1, x2, x3. So what is the covariance between x1, x2, x3? We should compute it because it is of 3 cross 3 matrix. So we compute covariance matrix of 3 cross 3. And intuition of PCA. So you can see there is E1, E2. We plotted all these data points, features are plotted. And we draw the best fit line, that is E1, E2. So once it is a best fit, then we just simply rotate it with respect to E2 as F2 and E1 as F1. So we'll be getting the projection from the 2D into 1D dimension space. That is reducing from 2 dimension to 1D dimension. So it shows how we compute principal components of the first principal component and principal component 2 and 3 and so on. So the projection of x on direction of w, which is given as z is equal to w transformation x. So you find the variance of z is maximized. So we computed variance of z and we get w transformation summation of w, and where variance of x is equal to e of x minus mu whole power transformation, which is equal to summation. And maximize variation of z subject to norm vector of w, which is equal to 1. So we get max w1 transformation summation of w1 minus alpha, and w1 transformation w1 minus 1. So this is what we calculated for principal component 1. Similarly, for second component again, we go for maximizing variation of Z2 such that norm vector W2 is equal to 1. Then we'll be getting the max W2 transformation summation of W2 minus alpha, W1 transformation W2 minus 1, and minus beta, the second component, W2 transformation W1 minus 0, and so on. So we'll be keep finding the number of components. Say it depends upon the dimensions. If we have 2 dimension, then we'll be having principal component 1 and principal component 2, and 3 dimension we'll get one more component, 4th dimension we'll be getting one more component, as it keeps going with the number of dimensions, we'll get number of principal component values. What PCS does, so as I said, we have Z1, Z2, all these are the errors shows here the plotted points, and here the line that we have drawn, right, Z1 and Z2, and we simply rotate the axis that so that Z1 becomes X1 and Z2 becomes X2, right? So we can see in such a way you'll get the all plotted points in lower dimension space. So PCA could have different implementations, but most popular ones are eigenvalue decomposition, that is AVD, and singular value decomposition, that is SVD. So eigenvalue decomposition, you can see the data matrix that is N cross M is given, that is X. So find a proper transformation, you transform this, that is you will get XT, that is transformation of this, that is N cross K. So this is standardized, so that is step A and step B. So X standardized, the data matrix X, and you give eigen decomposition, that is EVD. So the output will be getting X transformation, X into X transformation, that which is given as W, which contains all principal components, and D, which contains all ranks of vectors, that is ordered from the largest variance to least ones, that is rank, that is from highest value of component to lowest one, then WT transformation of W, right? So here again we can get the reverse of this, we get the N cross K matrix, the final matrix, that is we have N into M, X into X transformation into W, we'll be getting N cross K matrix. This is using EVD, and similarly we can also use SVD. So where we have standardized X matrix, and SVD is given along with that, so output you'll be getting X is equal to, that is original data matrix, and sigma V power T. So three matrix which contains principal components, vectors for two directions, that is column and row of raw data. So summation contains the rank of the principal components. So here you can see the step E where we have X and V, will be getting N cross K matrix. So that is XV will be getting it. So this is using EVD and SVD of the components, how the PCA could have implemented. So here you can see the original data set, say all these are X values and Y values. There are two features, X and Y. So X and Y are plotted here in two dimension. So how the X values are plotted here and Y values are plotted here separately. And here you just draw the line, as I said, the best line. And here it shows in a one color, and here it shows in orange color. Here you can see this is in a blue color, and say it is in orange color. So the output from PCA after rotating this, so that this line becomes X axis and this line becomes Y axis. So what we do is we see from top, like we see from top view. So whatever the data points it is plotted, we'll get it as a principal component one, right? So we see from top through this line, whatever the plotted lines, we'll get it as a PC component one. And similarly, we see through this line, right, from left view, we see from this view whatever the plotted lines, will get it like this, that as a principal component 2. So we see in two different directions, one is a top view and left view through the line. So we'll be getting two components, PC1 and PC2. And this is an algorithm. First one, we have the X, that is a data matrix, row vector, one row vector xn per data point, and we compute the we subtract mean x from each row vector, that is xn in x, then compute covariance matrix of x, find eigenvector, eigenvalues of summation, then pieces is found. So then find the largest pieces, ignore the remaining one. So that says the final pieces for the given entire data set. We'll see one by one. So you can see implementing PCA on that 2D data set. First you normalize it, as I was saying. First you normalize it. That is finding out mean and subtracted from all features. Normalize it, then calculate covariance using this matrix is equal to covariance of x comma x and covariance of x comma y and covariance of x comma y and covariance of x comma x 2, and calculate the eigenvalues and eigenvector. That is we have alpha and identity matrix, subtract A matrix, then find the determinant which is equal to 0. And step 4 is choose the components which is having high eigenvector value and choosing those values, then forming the principal components, that is new data which is can be feature vector transformation into scaled data transformation. So we'll be getting the new data set, that is after forming the principal components using all the math and we did. So we'll see this example. The data set which is given here is as two features, that is x1 and y1 or xy or x1 x2. So the variables p here is 2 and sample size n is equal to 10, that is n number of data points here. So here you can notice how this is plotted versus x comma y, right? These values are plotted. And first step, what we do is we want to normalize the data. So we find mean of the first feature and mean of second feature, right? So how do we do it? So we find out mean for this entire data feature and mean for this entire feature. So we'll be getting 1.81 for x1 or x and 1.91 for x2 or y, the whatever the name we give it. So this is the mean after we compute it. So here you can see, right? So I've taken as xy and for x mean is 1.81 and for y mean is 1.91. And once this is done, we move on to step 2, that is covariance has to be computed. What is a covariance matrix? So here there are two features, right? So that is two dimension, so 2 cross 2. So what we do is covariance of x comma x, covariance of x comma y and covariance of y comma x, covariance of y comma y. So here the covariance of x comma y, which is given like this, summation of I is 1 to n and xi minus the data from the feature x, and this is mean. So that is what we are doing here is mean is subtracted from all the data values of from xi, that is xi, and similarly y minus y mean value divided by n minus 1. And now we compute for covariance of x comma x. So x is given and x minus its mean, right? That is 1.81. so subtract 1.81 with all the values of x, we will be getting this value. And now what we do is we want to compute this, right? One, we have computed this and we want to multiply this with this. So here we are doing it for x comma x, so there is no y. So xi minus xi, so we multiply xi minus x mean, xi minus x mean, so that is we multiply this twice. So we'll be getting this sum is equal to 5.549 divided by n minus 1, right? That is the value of this x comma x. Similarly, we compute for x comma y and y comma y. So here y comma y is computed, that is all y here. You can see y minus y mean, yi minus y mean divided by n minus 1. Similarly, take the second feature data, that is y, and subtract the y mean from all the values, we'll be getting this, and multiply this twice to get this value. So I'll sum of all this are 6.449 divided by 9. So I'll be getting the value of covariance of y comma y. Similarly, compute for x comma y. So for x comma y, take the x value and y value and subtract the mean from all x, subtract mean of y from all y, we'll be getting the value. Then multiply these two, I'll be getting this column, and sum is equal to 5.539 divided by n minus 1, that is 9. Once this is computed, we got the covariance matrix, that is 0.6165 and 0.6154. So this is x comma x, this is x comma y, y comma x, both are same value, and this is y comma y. Once this is obtained, the covariance matrix is obtained, we move on to step 3, where we have C minus covariance minus here it is lambda into identity matrix, which is equal to 0. That is, we wanted to find the determinant of this. So identity matrix, which, what is identity matrix of a 2 cross 2? That is 1 0 0 1. If it is 3 cross 3, then it's going to be 1 0 0, then 0 1 0, then 0 0 1, right? So now multiplying lambda with this and again subtract this with this matrix, I'll be getting like this, right? After simplifying this, I'll be getting like this. Again, I'm trying to simplify this, I'll be getting lambda square minus 1.333 lambda minus 0.063 is equal to 0, right? Similarly, we can also get through this, that is lambda square minus transpose A, that is A matrix, and lambda plus determinant of A, which is equal to 0. If I again substitute this values, so what I'll be getting, the same equation what I have obtained already, right? The same equation that I'll be getting here. Either I can do with this or I can go with this, any one of this I can compute after computing covariance to obtain this equation, right? The marked one, right? So both are same. Now we want to obtain the eigenvalue. So eigenvalue, what we are getting is, that is the multiplicand of this value. So if I multiply 0.04048 into 1.84, I'll be getting this value. So that is the value of eigenvalues. So I named this as lambda 1 1.284, and so this is what the value of my PC principal component 1 I have taken as principal component 1. Lambda 2, that is 0.04908. Now what I do is, I take this equation, that is this determinant, and I substitute lambda 2 here. I will be getting this, which is multiplied with x1, x2, which is equal to 0. I will be getting these two equations. Solving this equation, x1, x2, I will be getting eigenvector. That is, substituting eigenvalue into this matrix, I will be getting this value, this matrix, and which is multiplied with x1, y1, which is equal to 0. So I'll be getting this equations. Solving this equations, x1, x, y1, so I'll be getting eigenvector, that is minus 0.735 and 0.677. these are the eigenvectors. Similarly, substituting alpha, that is sorry, lambda 1 into this equation, I'll be getting this matrix, which is multiplied with x2, y2, which is equal to 0. And solving this x2, y2, I'll be getting 0.678, 0.73. This is my PC1 for my data set, right? So this is my PC2 and this is my PC1 for my data set. So now I want to choose, there are two principal components, right? PC1 and PC2. So which component is having higher value? So now compare PC1 with PC2. So PC1 is the higher value. Choose that as an eigenvector for my entire data set, right? Instead of taking 2, I'll be taking only PC1, which is the highest value among the another PC component, PC2. That is my principal component 1 for my entire data set. So now again, P must be less than N. I have a 2 dimension, right? So there are two principal components. So here the principal component where it must be less than N. So I chose only 1. So it must be 1 is less than 2. Fine. So this is the final getting values of all, right? So the eigenvector values for lambda 1 and lambda 2, that is lambda 2 and lambda 1. So here it is given as lambda 1, but it is lambda 2. I'll be getting these values. And this is the principal component 1, which is 96%, the total variance. And this is 3.7%. So if I get this equation, get these eigenvectors, that is A matrix, that it is for the A matrix, and if I get the eigenvector, right, eigenvector, So this is what the eigenvector, the values, right? That is 0.678, 0.678, and 0.735, 0.735. So here what we take only this eigenvector values, because this is 96% each, right? Information capture. So we take only PC1, not PC2. We take only PC1, and we can see by checking this in step 5, divide the new data set by taking y is equal to x into v, right? So x into v. So we take both the this is y, right? So y is equal to this is x, that is x and y features, or x1 x2 features, which is multiplied with the vector, right? That is eigenvalue, that is the eigenvalues, that is eigenvector values. So multiply with both. So what happens? I am getting y is like this. If I plot this, I'll be getting like this. If I plot this, I'll be getting like this. But if I go by ignoring principal component 2 and multiply only with principal component 1, so this is principal component 1 value, that is with eigenvectors. If I multiply with x and y, or x1, x2 features, so I'll be getting y is equal to this. If I plot these values, in this case, I'll be getting PCA reduces to one dimension, right? So because we are going to ignore PC2, principal component 2, we'll be adding only principal component 1. So by this, I'll be getting only in one dimension for the entire data set, right? For the entire data set, I'll be having only one dimension, which is reduced into two dimension to one dimension. So this is the way how PC works. I hope this makes you very clear in understanding about PCA with this example. If anything else, please do comment. Thank you.